rule in favor of Otto Tower.
Thank you very much, Mayor, and thank you, Councilwomen, Councilmen. This will be at the PowerPoint.
But we don't have to lose it. Now, one of the things that we talked about at the town hall was many people who are leaders that you recognize who also remember what a jewel this is and why we should maintain it. And I'm going to quote a couple of people who are here right now, including, I see, on this document that I bring for you. I'm not showing any videos, but I'm showing this document that was presented last year talking about the Phoenix Center and Ottawa Towers. And we have here Council President, who says, and I quote him, this is his picture right here. Default means the city could risk going back to court, and at that point, it's very likely that the city would be served with a judgment levy. Judgment levy of $30 million would be visited on every man, woman, and taxpayer in the city of Pontiac and Providence.
Mayor, one second, Mayor. Desk, Mayor, one
second. Help desk that we had. I'm the mayor. hold on one second.
My question really is, if there is no community plan or vision for the Phoenix Center, why take out a piece of money and not get to where you need to get to in order to build something that's going to generate revenue in the future and come back?
Of course, that's not a finance question. That's a strategic question. And
can you guys please stop giving me the call? Okay, so
good deal. Know where the Phoenix Center is. I'm going to know where the big tent in downtown is. Everybody knows where the big tent in downtown is.
Hidden River Park has now become a Kaboom Grant nominee, or regardless, they're going to be getting some money for it. And it's hard to say that a park for kids isn't a good idea. I mean, come on, I have kids. But however, I do not want my kids playing anywhere near that park.
Hidden River Park has been the source of a lot of projects going on. In fact, the neighborhood empowerment projects, I think we got quite a bit of money over the last 2 years to do that. And Jim and Monica happen to know a lot about it because they actually brought the idea to us and were partners in the grant, consultants on that particular grant. So, and I think your idea is well taken because it is multi-purpose. This isn't just, we got 28 parks in the city of Pontiac. Some of them are playground, parks. This is part of a greater idea. I think one of the things you brought in was to have a
shipping.
To have
yeah, shipping container that acts as a stage.
Not, it's not a exclusive playground park. It also has other features that have to do, which it has been used.
Nothing from nothing beats nothing. You gotta have something if you wanna be with me.
It's my understanding that there were playground instruments already, and so we've already were using the buffer for that park. So it won't change anything with regard to the buffers that were already established.
We're having our fountain turned into a flower bed.
I think they should have kept it a water song because it helps the world. Because the earth is rough.
No, the closing date is set for January 4th. It's going to be hard for everybody to meet that now. Every day, every week we lose. Mm-hmm. Is difficult. All right.
Week off.
So I just want to keep that in mind every time we move this back.
Y'all got us in
a
situation in the first place. And I'm trying to get us out of it. And so I will not be bullied into signing a bad agreement when we can fix it for Tuesday. It just doesn't.
Things. And so Pontiac's voice really needs to be there. It needs to be, you know, at the table. And so this is what comes next. And I love this shot. I know people have used it before. I love the fact that this was the old life of that top of the Phoenix Center, but you know what? It could be the new life all over again. Theater, maybe it's named something different. You know, maybe it's the United Wholesale Mortgage, you know, amp. Who knows, right? Who knows what could be out there?
Accordingly, in connection with Council's approved resolution on March 9th, there is not a location available for the Council representative to attend the closing.
Thank you. I wanted the general public to know that the resolution that we passed to be notified of the closing did not happen. I wanted to let my Pontiac City Council colleagues know that there was no communication given to me from the mayor of a closing date or a closing time. As of 5:00, I did receive an update picture and image that says that the deal is currently closed and they have a special town hall meeting that they will be having at 1:00 tomorrow without the council.
You see my picture in your little brochure? Yeah! Guess what? I want your picture to be in the brochure. You see the Phoenix Center down there?
Yeah!
We don't have any idea what to do with it. We've spent millions of dollars building it, and guess what? It's wide open and empty.
Just look to your left and you'll see the most important people in this county. Just look to your left and say thank you for being so important. All right? All right. Thank you so much. I recognize that we haven't been together in a couple of years. And to come back to this exciting facility. Look up, this is pretty good. Man, I thought it would be all raggedy and everything. But it looks good, doesn't it? And we're gonna do a lot of great things out of this facility. And thank the mayor and her team and the city council for bringing it back.
Hello, Pontiac. Welcome to the 2021 State of the City, and thank you for coming. This is as symbolic as tonight marks the first time in, say, 8 years that we have been able to utilize this facility, which we still claim right of ownership of, right here in the amphitheater. And tonight, to celebrate the new public-private partnership, the deal that we formed to realize this win-win for the city of Pontiac, to be able to maintain this facility, this amphitheater that we remember so many nostalgic events that we had here, right? As citizens of Pontiac, that after a long trial and tribulation, we were able to work out a wonderful deal in which we are still able to utilize this facility, and tonight to symbolize that we are revitalizing that opportunity and that ownership for the city of Pontiac, we're going to light up this canopy right here. We're going to light it up as a symbol and as a beacon for all who come to Pontiac to remember what has happened with this facility for the citizens of Pontiac who are proud of what it is. I know a lot of you haven't been up here in a long time, but it looks great, doesn't it? Is it what you remember? All right. What was the Phoenix Center when I came in as mayor in 2014? Remember back then, the emergency manager had ordered the demolition of the Phoenix Center garage because the city didn't have any money to take care of the repairs. And over the years, the repairs and the damage got worse and worse. And so when he ordered the demolition, he put us into a terrible situation with the owners of Ottawa Towers, who sued us. And that was the old owners. And we were in litigation for a number of years until, through mediation, we were able to have a settlement agreement that brought us to the stage where we could now reach what we have most recently signed is a public-private partnership with the new owners of Ottawa Towers, who are also going to be partners in how we develop and utilize the Phoenix Center Amphitheater. That's where we are now. And it's brought us to the point where we are going to have that inaugural lining of the Phoenix Center canopy shortly after a little while. And it was because of the fact that council did vote to sign a public-private partnership opening a new deal for the city of Pontiac. In addition to that, I was able to craft a memorandum of understanding to make sure that this public-private partnership would include what is important to me as equally as the closing papers, make sure we had citizen participation, make sure we had jobs, and even revenue sharing arriving out of this partnership deal. And the future vision of what this could mean for the city of Pontiac was that the Phoenix Center and solving the problem that we had here was also going to help to revitalize our whole downtown. And as I've talked with our partners in this deal, there's great ideas for how we can develop this amphitheater. For example, we hear talk of maybe a new library, displacing the library that we have now that is outgrown its current facility. Maybe doing business and performing arts incubators right here in these sites. Reviving the festivals and the fairs. How many of you remember the things that we came up here for on the top of the amphitheater? Yes, Senator, I know a lot of people remember those days. Green space. We have green space ideas. Also, we have the possibility of doing wraparound housing and retail. There's a lot of things that can be done on this acreage and a lot of innovative ideas. Maybe even a corporate headquarters for some corporation who wants to come into Pontiac and relocate and establish here. Those are all kinds of things that can happen. So I wanted to also recognize for this event people who have helped with that Phoenix Center amphitheater development, and that is Lee Contracting, which has enabled us to have this event by having the industrial generators that bring up the temporary power. You know, we won't be fully ready to utilize this until all the repairs have been done, but we were able to, with their help, just get the temporary and transitional lighting and electricity so we could enjoy this evening today.